It's time we give this desert village a bigger purpose. We're going to use this space to store all of our building materials. It's going to be convenient and organized and also colorful and full of life, and it gives us an excuse to actually interact with the world around us. You're watching Bambi Builds, and this is episode 28. So last week, we kind of already started on this by moving all of our wood into this storage room, which is organized into little mini biomes. The birch wood and the bamboo wood are the ones that we'll mostly be using throughout the desert village. And now beside the building, we have all this space to fill in. And I want to start by seeing what's behind this wall and if it's a space that we can actually use. Okay, so I got a little bit carried away and I built all of the basic structures, but don't worry, we're going to make this all look a lot prettier. So we've got four little market stalls where our villagers can sell different products, and then they need somewhere to actually sleep, so we've got a bit of space back here. Nothing too crazy, room for five or six villagers. And then upstairs, we have two more houses. A cute little sky bridge here leading to the rest of the village. Up here is just a classic Bambi desert home. And another one over here. There's another little sky bridge there. And a few walkways over here connecting back to the original village. I'm quite happy with how this is all feeling. We just need to add a bit of life to it. I did notice a villager walk off the edge here earlier. They think the trapdoors are like this, so they step on it and fall off the edge. So I'll have to get rid of those. Another thing that I already built is this smelting station. Basically, you grab some buckets, grab your lava, then we place that in this chest to fuel our furnace, and then we place our materials in this chest that will filter through, and it ends up down here. So we will be using this for sandstone a lot. And over here, I just want to store a couple of things that I use all the time, but I don't have an actual shop for just yet. Like sticks. We always need sticks. And now we need to decide what's going to actually go in these shops. Terracotta springs to mind. That is something that we need easy access to as we continue to expand this village. This market stall is not quite big enough. I believe there are 16 colours plus plain terracotta. So none of these are going to work. Maybe this? This will be a big enough space? Okay, so in our storage room at home, we have most of the different colors already, even some glazed. So I will grab all of these and transport them back to the village. We don't have black terracotta, so I'm just gonna grab some dye. Now we make grey terracotta and brown terracotta. Organize them all into a rainbow. Put all the blocks away. And that looks pretty good. Next, we want to organize our glazed terracotta. So we will need a space for 16 barrels, ideally 4x4. The ceiling is too low in these stalls. This would fit all of the barrels, but I think it'd be a bit messy. And this is kind of a major walkway too, so I don't really want to put them there. So this used to be 2 blocks wider, but I brought it in just to accommodate this sky bridge. Maybe we can change it back. Just need to make sure the ceiling can be removed. Oh, it can. Yeah, that might work. So that works, I think. And this one can be bricks and granite. Now we are just missing a block of lime terracotta. And then we are going to glaze one of each color. Now we need to organize these into some kind of rainbow. In rows of 4. We're missing one. Blue terracotta it was. Alright, there we go. Now that's all organized. Now let's organize the brick and granite. And clay as well. Might as well go there. Now this birch wood is not a vibe, so let's get rid of that. And replace it with something more fitting. Oh yeah, that makes it very clear what's being sold here. Now we should do the same here. We can use terracotta, but we won't be able to craft it into slabs or walls, unfortunately. So we'll have to use some kind of wood. Cute. Let's try crimson wood. Conveniently stored here in our wood room. You know what? I like it. It looks good. Warped wood. A little bit too nethery. Yeah, that makes more sense. We have heaps of these. Might as well use them up here. Oh yeah, that looks good. I think a brick wall back here would be nice. Yeah, that's cute. Next up, we have concrete, another one of my favorite building blocks. We have lots of pink, lots of yellow, and white. And the rest we'll have to craft. I'm pretty sure most of the dyes are stored in our shepherd's house at the moment. So we might as well get rid of all of these barrels as well. Then we need gravel. And our sand is up here. Should probably store all this in the desert too. Craft up all the other colors. Now let's do this the fun way. Village looks kind of small from up here. Cute though. All right, let's get back down and get to mining. Don't know why the blocks just go everywhere. Okay, here is our concrete rainbow. Might as well widen this and do it properly. Yeah, that's good. Now for the counter, we want another cute little rainbow. Oh, hello. Better fix that. All right, that one's done. And sandstone, probably the most relevant to the desert. We're also going to store our gravel here so we can easily make concrete. And decorating this is going to be super easy. Okay, so we've got our main building blocks sorted, but what about the rest of the stuff we always use in our builds? Like the pots and the plants? Where are we going to store those? It needs to be somewhere nearby because we use them a lot. So we should probably store our pots in here. Oh, we already do. Cool. I'm sure there are more at home though, surely. And here we have a whole bunch of flowers on display, but we don't actually store them here. Overcrowded village. Plenty of room here to throw some chests down and store the flowers in here. So now let's go back to our storage room at home and just spend a little while gathering all of the materials and taking them over to our desert village. We have all this sandstone that still needs to go over. I think this is going to take me quite a while, so I won't bore you by showing you everything. But I will show you all the plants that we'll be taking across as well. Okay, so we have our most popular desert plants at the front here. Then we have more inside. Now, I want to use these as decoration. I think they look so, so cute. Yeah, I love that. Now I'm spending about an hour clearing out my storage room at home and moving everything important into the desert village. Now I'm giving the villagers a bit of a nicer living space, just using some concrete and some basic decorations, so they have a nice place to come and rest at night. Now I'm adding some colour to this new section of the village using banners and plants. And now that we have this beautiful new town square, I think we need another custom tree. Yeah, that looks so good. Before I give you the final tour, there is one thing missing. As we expand our village, I'd like to add more village bells. So now it's time for us to go on a little adventure to find some village bells. Okay, I might be a little lost, but I think I'm heading in the right direction. Oh, a torch! Oh, we've been here before. Oh, I know exactly where we are. This is our dig site from episode 2. And there's still a brush here, so we might as well use it. This place is massive. I gave up halfway through last time. Mud bricks! Gimme, gimme! We love mud bricks! We'll find some treasures. Ooh, pottery. Okay, I've been here for half an hour. I think I've had enough. Look at all of the stuff we have here. So many beautiful treasures. So I'm going to pick the best stuff and take it back to the village now. Fill up this boat chest. Grab a couple more things. And follow these torches home. Okay, I'm going to get organized and then we can place the bell and call this project finished. Let's start with a tour of the inside. Nothing too fancy, just some concrete floors, some bedrooms and bookshelves, some random holes in the wall for airflow. Some gravel scattered around the place because these villages are concreters. Very simple decorations because we're not actually going to use this space. We are going to spend all of our time out here. It's so beautiful, so colourful, so organised. I just love it so much. Got our sniffers here. This is where I'm storing some banners, just for now. And some moss over here. We might have to set up some shops for those in the future. But that'll do for now, just so I have easy access. Here is our sandstone, sand and gravel, which we use to make concrete. We have our essentials here for now. Sticks, barrels, chests, item frames, just for my own convenience. An infinite source of fuel. And a smelting area. And of course, our beautiful tree. Oh, and our village bell. This is where the villagers will gather. And of course, our wood storage area. Upstairs, we have our walkways leading to the older section of the village. And we have a bunch of villagers standing around. I know what they want. They want the barrels. They all want to be fishermen. Anyway, up here we have our houses, which I forgot to decorate. More little walkways to the older sections of the village. I love that. Nice view here. And I'm guessing I forgot to decorate this house as well. So we'll just have a look under here. Placed a few things around. And of course, our old village. I think this whole space is a beautiful addition to our village. And having everything here is going to prevent future chest monsters from building up. Speaking of, this is not a chest monster. This is, sure, I still need to organize this one. And that one. But these are here for a reason. Each chest represents a future shop that we are going to build. For example, lanterns. We use lots of lanterns all the time. Scaffolding. We need a place to store this and also a place to grow bamboo. Maybe not in the desert. Some kind of ocean-themed store. Item frames. Copper. Campfires. We currently store them at the fishing hut. Because you can trade with the villagers for campfires. But maybe we'll build a dedicated store. Glass, made from sand, so very deserty. Beds. Our villagers need beds. Mud. I love mud. This will probably go somewhere in the jungle. We don't really use mud bricks in the desert. Workstation blocks. Maybe we have some kind of job find center. That would be kind of funny. And a music store or like collectibles or something. I'm not really sure. So yeah, we've got a few ideas for future builds there. Let me know if anything is jumping out at you. I do have a lot of ideas, but I love hearing your suggestions as well. I hope you loved this episode. Thank you so much for watching Bambi Builds. I'll meet you back here next week.